Mech lab in the back and the crack smoke peels through the streets like an early morning fog. Mama's in the slaughterhouse with the hatchet, helping dad did chop early morning hog. I'm catching Z's like an early morning saw when I woke up to the racket, yawning pause. What the fuck, man, I can never get sleep, man, peeped out the window.
What up with you, Bootleg?
Man, I know Vegas is like your second home, man.
Man, I've been spending a lot of time here lately, man.
Recording the album out here?
Yeah, I did Radioactive, my freshman release coming out on Shady. I recorded here at my boy Molly Mall's spot with the Audibles, Pooh Bear. We brought Willpower out here.
Don't forget the cheetah.
Oh, yeah. By the way, Molly's got a cheetah in his house, you know? So don't try anything shady over near Molly's house. On top of that, he's got two timber wolves in the yard.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, and a monkey named Bubs.
That's what's up. I just want to congratulate you, man. The hard work has paid off. You're on Shady now. That's big.
Oh, man. I couldn't be... I feel right at home over at Shady, man. Like, everybody's cool, you know. Everybody's focused and ready. We're ready, man. You know, yeah, we're in there making music and just killing it right now. I'm proud of the crew, man. And yeah, M is killing it. You know, 10 nominations for Grammys this year. He took some home this year, so Shady's looking good already.
Yeah, it's funny because, like, the last freshman cover that came out last year, I thought you got snubbed, but it's all good because you're on the cover of XXL anyway, so.
Yeah, man. I made it one way or another. But the XXL, man, they really hold me down, man.
For sure.
The staff up there, they've always held me down, man. So I got a lot of love for XXL. But yeah, man, you know. And put me on the squad and landed the cover.
Now, that first meeting you had with Eminem, like the first time you guys sat down and talked, like, what was that conversation like, man? Was he just telling you how big of a fan of yours he was, or?
You know, when we went up there, it was a meet and greet. At least that's what I thought it was anyway. I thought we were just going up there just to holler, you know, as label mates and, you know, obviously just to shake hands and, you know. Little did I know at that point that it was actually initiating a possible situation with Shady.
When you went to meet M, you had no idea.
No, I had no clue. My crew didn't even tell me I had a deal with Shady till like toward the end. They're like, crazy. "Yo, you got a deal with Shady," respectively, because you know I wouldn't want to be let down from something that big.
Yeah.
If it didn't happen,
come through. Yeah.
Yeah, but they waited for it to come to be solid to let me know and But yeah, you know, he had gave Trump Music a listen after my first meeting with him. He had heard it. Yeah, and it was just an honor, man, you know, for dude to even, you know, to care, you know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
To even be listening. But he's a true fan, man. You know, the more I kick it with him, you know, he knows a lot that's going on. You'd be surprised how many artists he knows about on the underground,
right?
You know, that are coming
he's up.
He
keeps his, he's up on yeah, his stuff, yeah.
Keeps his ear out. So luckily,
most definitely.
I made the cut. You know.
Hey, most definitely. I wanted to ask you too. I know your mom's got a Twitter, right?
Yeah, MamaWolf7. Follow at MamaWolf7, and you know she's famous.
I saw that. I was like, wait. Because I think she started to follow me or something, and I was like, who's this?
My mom is on Twitter hard.
It's Yela, and yo, she tweets a lot.
And she kills it. She's actually more entertaining than I am. So just follow Mama. She's super proud. Actually, it's Mom's birthday. Happy birthday, Mama. She's out here in Vegas tonight. She's going to come check out the show at the Ghost Bar. If y'all are out and about,
yes.
You know, y'all
want to
come check out the show, come holler at me. I'm at the Palms. Top floor of the Palms at the Ghost Bar.
It's going down.
Hey, I'm on the marquee, Bootleg.
You are on the marquee.
Big time, dog.
Yo, you gotta get a picture of that, son.
Give it to the
mom to throw in the scrapbook. That's so major right there. Now, I want to talk to you about Radioactive, man, because I know you just dropped the Trump Music 0 to 60 not too long ago.
Yeah.
And that was, you know, it was pretty much half and half between older stuff and newer stuff. What can we expect? Like, is there going to be an M collaboration on Radioactive, or?
I tell you this. I will leave an element of surprise to Radioactive, and I'm not gonna tell anybody none of my features, and I'll tell you why. Everything is so accessible.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like you on Twitter, online, you can find out so much that I'm gonna try to protect.
All
I'm gonna try to protect this to the end.
Even what about production wise? Can you?
Nah, I'm not even gonna talk about that. You know, there's got to be some kind of mystery in the game.
I saw that Bun was in the studio with you out here. I did see that, but that doesn't mean he's going to be on Radioactive. But
nah, that was me and Bun were in a green room shooting Good to Go.
It just came out today.
Yeah, today Good to Go just dropped. So
that first verse, it took me forever to learn that verse. But
you learned it?
Yeah. What a lingo. Part. Yeah, that's my shit.
Go ahead.
I don't want to mess it up. That's my joint, though.
That's tight.
Yeah.
Hey, come out tonight, you can spit it.
I'll have to do that, man. And hey, did you see? I don't know if you saw, but your label mates were holding you down, man. Slaughterhouse, they had like an interview in New York, and that Charlamagne the God dude was hating on you.
Really?
Like, heavy.
Who is who?
That you know, you haven't heard of Charlamagne the God? He's big on Twitter.
Nah, I never heard of him.
Okay, yeah, well, Slaughterhouse was holding you down.
He's big on Twitter though.
Yeah, that's probably about.
Watch
it.
Watch out. He's big on Twitter. Cyber thugs.
Oh my goodness.
And, internet gangsters. Internet goons.
Have you I know M's close with Dre. Have you got to meet Dre yet or?
Which by the way, I know that Royce and Button and the Slaughterhouse crew held me down and Angela Yee held me down.
Yes, she did.
And you know, it is what it is, man. You know, I'm living my dream, and I'm becoming a figure, you know what I'm saying?
I just don't understand how, like, that dude could have heard, like, Trump music. He said he listened to it, but if he did, and he's from the South, and have a negative opinion on it, that's crazy, man.
Yeah, man. Well, you know, it's I make artwork for people to it's what I do, man. You know what I'm saying? I am to be judged. That's my cross, you know, that's what I've been given. Like, you're either going to hate me or you're going to love me. You know, there is no in between, you know, like, my fans are core fans. But I tell you this, I got the greatest allies on the planet. So, as far as, like, if you're in a place of power and you plan on running your mouth, you know, you should probably think twice about it because, the allies that I'm surrounded by are the most talented, the most brilliant, and the most influential people
in music.
Definitely. Period. And I'm thankful for that. That's why I don't need to talk much. So
I wanted to also
moving
ask you,
on.
Of course, you know, from you've been doing the music thing for a long, long time. Have you felt like the change in, you know, when you go out to the mall or whatever since you know, being on tour with Yelawolf to, you know, before that, or being on tour with Wiz before that, dropping Trunk Music, and now you're on the cover of XXL. Does it feel different? Like you're getting to be huge, man.
Nah, it's of course, you know, it feels
marquee totally on the palms. Different.
Nah, it's, man, you know, like being from Alabama and coming out and making these moves and making these connections, you know, it's just unreal. Like the type of experiences that I'm going through right now, and seeing where I come from, the sticks, man. If I go home to my mom and pop's house right now,
yeah,
you know, out in the flat woods of Rainbow City, or go to my boy Shawty Fast Hood and Oakley Estates, you know, where it's just slummed out, or the trailer parks, and to see where I'm at right now, you know, I might as well hit the lottery. I've been so blessed. But it took tireless work, persistence. You know, this didn't fall in my lap. Don't get it twisted up, right. You know. It is a blessing. But, you know, I took 10 steps, you know what I'm saying? God took 20,
that's,
you know.
Man.
I take 100 steps. He takes 200 steps, you know, and that's how it works, man. And I've always just put faith in myself, man. And, you know, here I am. And yes, it feels great. It does feel different. Definitely. It feels different to go out and buy my mom dinner for her birthday.
Yeah.
Pay my bills, you know, or if I want a pair of spokes for my Chevy, I could go get it, you know.
I'm not thinking about it. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not like, I'm, if I want, you know, some fresh kicks, if I want to be good to go, I'm good to go, you know, and, but nothing comes without making good music, and I always put my music first, period, before anything. I put my artwork first, And that for that, I've been rewarded, man, you know, definitely. And being a purist about this music and respecting the game and respecting the OGs in the game and reaching out to those who inspired me first instead of reaching down to up-and-coming artists. You know, I'm reaching up. I'm trying to, you know, I'm reaching my hand up to get pulled up by the OGs, because without them, we don't even exist. So you gotta pay your dues and show respect to the elders in the game, man, who have put it down before you.
And Radioactive is done. Is it done or?
Radioactive is finished. Outside of
a few
locking down these special features, man.
That's what's up. When's like the target before 2012 or what?
Yeah. We're going for this summer. That's the goal, you know? So I'm putting it out there. Radioactive summer release. You know, speak it into existence. Definitely we got the music. We're ready, you know?
And I had a lot of chicks hit me on Twitter, man, that are in love with you, and they would just want to know if you're single.
Oh, man. Well, I'll tell you this.
Depends on what city you're in.
Yeah, great answer.
It's like, you know, it depends. If I'm in Toronto, yes. You
know? Yeah. It depends on what city I'm in.
That's what it is. Baby.
You know, I don't really like. I save that for the records. You know, save that. I save all that talk for my records. You can hear exactly what I'm about. Just press play.
I wanted to ask you. This is the first time I interviewed you. Is the what's up with the girl from Love Is Not Enough? Man, is that a real female that you wrote that about?
Man, you know what? I. Dude, that was a real situation, but respectably, I didn't, I said no names, right. I didn't say real times, I didn't say real specific locations, because, you know, even though that did happen, I know that that could have turned into something real ugly for that particular person and whoever she might be with at this point. So just in honor of that, I ain't going to shout nobody out and drop nobody's name, because I know how powerful that is. But, yeah, it's from a real situation.
That's what's up, man. Well, hey, I appreciate the time, dude. I'm a big fan.
Bootleg Kev, coming in hot.
That's what it is.